evening, Professor. Returning from work, I take it? I commend you for working so late into the evening. All of my days at the Academy are enriching thanks to you. Try not to overtax yourself, all right? I'm concerned for your health. We wouldn't want you to wear yourself out. The goddess won't smite you if you rely on others for help, you know. Listen here, Professor. You might not like what I'm about to say. To be perfectly honest, I had my doubts when I first met you. At first, I thought you seemed too young to be a professor. It is unusual, you have to admit. Yet you seemed very composed and mature despite your age. You're strong-willed, encouraging, and you go to great lengths to ensure that everyone is cared for. But it almost feels like you're trying too hard to be a perfect role model for your students. If that's how you feel, then I can't disagree. But I think it's necessary to give yourself a break every now and again. The mind has a tendency to make mistakes when you've exhausted yourself. In my case, I still seem to make mistakes even when I'm wide awake. Oh, you know, I'm always mixing up the dates for drills or misplacing things. Just the other day, I forgot to put on my uniform and headed out to practice wearing only my... Well, you can imagine how embarrassed I was. My mind can be so scattered sometimes. Anyway, where was I? Ah, that's right. What I'm trying to say is that you shouldn't push yourself too hard. If you do, you might end up in a pretty bad place. That reminds me, is there anything I can do to assist you, Professor? If it's all right with you, I'd like to help in any way I can. Whatever you need, just say the word. I look forward to helping you out.
Professor. Hello, Professor. Do you have a moment? Well, I have this book of battle tactics that I borrowed from one of the knights. There's one part that I just don't understand. Do you think you could explain it to me? Great, thank you so much. It's about this diagram here. I don't get why the knights are grouping up in that forest there. I just can't see the advantage to a formation like that. Yay, I finally get it. You really are a great teacher. I knew asking you was the right idea. I just love learning new things. That's why I came to the Officer's Academy. I want to learn magic, battle tactics, martial arts, and well, all kinds of stuff. I'm learning more now than I have in my whole entire life. Speaking of, I'd better go visit the library for some research before magic practice, which is just before sword training. That's just not possible. I always find it's more tiring to laze around doing nothing. I've never been any good at that. I have to have something to do. Like, on my days off, I need to get up early and take care of the cleaning first, or I just can't relax. Know what I mean? Oh, I'm so glad you agree. You'd be surprised how rare it is to find people like us. Mercy never sets foot outside her room on her days off. I don't get that girl sometimes. Not to mention... Oh, wait. Oh, no! I was supposed to be on cooking duty today! I completely forgot! Sorry, Professor, but I have to run. Thanks again for your help! Ah! Who put this stupid barrel here?!
Wow, Ash, training again? You're taking this whole knight thing pretty seriously.
It's just my daily training. Maybe you could stand to be a little more eager yourself? If I want to be a great knight, I've got no choice but to put the effort in.
No choice? I think you're making life too difficult. Knights don't have to be perfect. All I'm saying is, I've seen some pretty sloppy knights out there.
That's not going to be me. I'm going to be a proud knight, virtuous and gallant.
Virtuous and gallant? Are you kidding me? If you just ride around being virtuous, people will get fed up. They'll boot you out of town.
It's never wrong to have virtue, not even if it means being made an outcast.
Interesting idea. You think very highly of this whole virtue thing. Say, have there been any knights who became great just by thinking highly of themselves? Think on this. Knights are supposed to protect people and earn their admiration. Isn't that right?
Well, yes. So what are you saying I should do?
Seize people's hearts!
What do you mean?
You want people to love you? Offer them something they haven't got. Guess what that is? It's you, Ash. They don't have you. Get out there, buddy. Be valiant. Help people. Here, I'll show you how it works.
Sylvain, don't go bothering people.
Hey there, cutie. You seem to have lots of bags there. They must be heavy. My name's Sylvain. Let me help you out. Are these going in the warehouse?
Helping out those in need, I guess that's a good start.
No thanks necessary. It's been enough just to be able to talk to you. Well, if you insist, how about we go get some tea? It must be fate that we met like this. I'd like to get to know you.
Great knight, huh? More like a great philanderer. Seems like all he wants to do is flirt with women. No, I can't allow this. I have to stop him.
That shopping trip took longer than expected, didn't it, Mercy?
It truly did. You bought just about everything in the place.
You're so good at deciding the best thing to buy. I sort of wanted it all. I mean, not that I was excessive. I think you bought just about as much as I did.
Oh, really? The number of bags you're carrying says otherwise.
What? That's... Oh, fine. You got me. I was just having too much fun. I love shopping with you, Mercy.
It was fun. It's nice going into town without having to run errands for once.
Isn't it? And I'm pretty confident the professor will forgive our little detour. This actually reminds me of going to school in Ferdiad.
Me too. It almost feels like that time in our lives was a story from long ago.
So much has changed since then. Oh, but there's at least one thing that hasn't changed.
Me and you, right? We're the same old friends we always were.
That's just what I was about to say.
I've known you so long, I can always guess.
Mercy, we'll stay friends like this forever, won't we?
Is something wrong? You sound worried.
Since our time in the capital, so much has happened. We've had to make new lives for ourselves, and we've seen at least as many hard times as good. If things keep changing like this, I wonder if we'll be able to stay the same people we are now.
I wonder that too. I don't think everything in the future will be perfect, but it's us. So I'm sure...
we'll figure it out together, right?
How did you know what I was going to say?
Oh, Mercy, I can always guess what you're gonna say.
Oh, it's getting late. We better hurry back before the professor gets angry.
You're right. Run, Mercy!
What? Wait for me, Annie! You know I'm not as fast as you!
Run!
Nightfall? Already? Suppose I'd better wrap up.
Good work with your training today, Ingrid. Here's something to wipe up the sweat.
Whoa, Mercedes. Hi. Hello. How long have you been... Thank you.
You're very welcome. I've been here since you started.
Not long. Huh. Well, my apologies for not having noticed you. I get so caught up in training, you know. But why are you here? I can't imagine it was too terribly interesting watching me.
I disagree. I just couldn't help but admire your training technique. I have to say, you are very impressive. I'm nowhere near as graceful as you.
Graceful? I wouldn't say that, but thank you. If I'm to be honest, I'm the one who admires you.
Goodness, me? How so?
You're always so put together. You hold yourself with such poise and have such a keen eye for fashion. I mean, even the handkerchief you handed me smells like... lavender, is it?
It's just lovely. That perfume is a favorite of mine. I'm so glad you like it.
Even the fact that you thought to put perfume on your handkerchief is delightfully foreign to me. I'd never have thought of that.
I'll gladly share some with you. You're welcome to come visit my room whenever you'd like. We can have tea and chat. How does that sound?
That sounds really nice. Yes. Sipping tea and having a chat. It's unlike me, but it sounds lovely.
From now on, we'll meet up whenever we have time. We can go right now if you're free.
Oh, no need to trouble yourself and rearrange things for me.
It's no trouble at all. You'll never know if you're the type who enjoys chatting over tea if you never try.
All right, then.
Hello, Ingrid. Can I have just a teeny tiny moment of your time?
Sure. I can spare a moment or two.
I was wondering, do you have any interest in fashion and makeup and stuff like that?
I haven't the time to bother with such frivolities. As long as basic hygiene is being met, then I'm happy.
Oh, but you're missing out on something so fun. I mean, it's not like you need it, of course. You've got beautiful bone structure, lovely hair, long legs, but aren't you interested in trying something new?
Well, thank you. I suppose I do find it all somewhat intriguing. But my time is precious to me, and my focus is on knighthood. Taking time to paint my face simply isn't a top priority.
Sure, but imagine if you could combine the two and become the most fabulous knight ever. Okay, maybe I'm taking it too far. I know knights don't necessarily need a ton of makeup or things like that for the job. I'm just saying, I really think you'd enjoy it if you opened your mind to it. All I'm talking about is a light touch. I can see it now. Your gorgeous face done up with a delicate application of makeup. The fabulous knight who everyone looks up to and wants to be.
Well, maybe? I guess. That does sound mostly harmless.
Hooray! Okay, we don't have a moment to lose. Here, take this makeup kit, play around with the colors, and see what speaks to you.
Now, wait just a...
I actually got that little kit as a gift the other day, and I wasn't sure what to do with it because I already have that one. It's a limited palette, but I think it fits the look you're going for perfectly.
I actually never agreed to start putting that stuff on my face, Annette.
What? Oh, well then, I guess this whole kit will have to go to waste. I'll just throw it away like the garbage it is.
You're throwing it away? I can't just stand by and let something go to waste. Okay. All right. Thank you. We can do this.
That's the spirit! Oh, and I'm happy to help you learn to apply it too. Come on, let's go to my room. I have some brush techniques to show you before you get started.
Now, don't get carried away.
Ugh. She played me like a fiddle.
Thank you for sparring with me, Your Highness. It seems despite how hard I've worked, I'm still no match for you.
Oh, there's no need for such humility. Thanks to all of your hard work, you're improving rapidly.
If you're going to praise me, it should at least be after I've won a match against you.
You know, Ingrid, I may be the victor when we cross spears on foot like this. But on horseback, your handling of a lance is far superior. Can't I be allowed to have my own area of expertise?
No, I cannot allow that. It's my duty to get stronger, to fight with all I have in defense of the kingdom and its people.
Such high stakes. By the way, where did you learn that fierce jab of yours? I'm pretty sure the only other person I've seen perform that move is Glenn.
So you recognized it? Yes, he shared much with me.
I thought as much. I never imagined I would be on the receiving end of one of his techniques again. Glenn and I once studied under the same instructor. I've sparred with him more times than I can count.
Ah, yes. He was never short on praise for you. Lord Dimitri is incredible. Such skill. There's no way I'll ever outmatch him. Things of that sort.
Well, now, he never said any of that to me.
Well, he was Felix's brother. That family's not big on displays of affection.
That is true. We spent about as much time arguing as we did training. I can't believe it's been 4 years since the tragedy of Dusker. Since we lost Glenn, along with so many others.
So it has. Time moves quickly. Things have changed so much. Despite the sorrow, I intend to become a powerful knight. A knight like yourself. And like Glenn. I will do so for the sake of my homeland, the Holy Kingdom of Fargus, and for all who have died protecting it. To that end, I hope you will spar with me again in the future, Your Highness.
It would be my pleasure. After all, I value our training sessions as much as you do.
I must have left it in the library. Oh, is that Felix? Hey, Felix. This is a surprise. I didn't think you had much interest in books. I'm already finished with that one. You can borrow it if you'd like.
No need. I was just curious who it belonged to.
Why not read a few pages at least, while you've got it open? I think you'd really like it. The plot is pretty different from a typical Knight's Tale, but it's still really good. Do you like stories about adventure and chivalry?
No, I despise them.
Yeah, well, have you tried reading any? You might find them really interesting. I know I do.
What do you find so interesting?
Well, for one thing, the knights in these stories are always gallant and brave. And they always value things like friendship, loyalty, and justice. That's the kind of knight I want to be.
Ridiculous. Friendship, loyalty, justice. Only fools allow their lives to be ruled by such nonsense. Fools who get themselves killed for nothing, only to be celebrated as heroes in books like this. Writers of these stories are worse than tyrants. They seize control of people's thoughts.
That's a little much. I was only interested in...
I don't care. Such blind enthusiasm is dangerous. Be more moderate in your passions.
You know something, Felix? You are exactly like the knight in this story.
Excuse me?
On the surface, he's sarcastic and intimidating, but underneath, he's kind and cares for his friends. In the end, they become heroes together and conquer all obstacles.
Disgusting. Stop looking at me like that.
Oh, see, right there. That's just what I mean. You sound exactly like him. I'm going to lend you this book, really, I insist. Just give it a read, all right? Trust me, and you can tell me what you think when you're done.
Why is this happening?
Felix, there you are. I've been looking all over for you. Time for our tactics lecture. You'll be there, won't you?
Those things are such a waste of time.
Nonsense. You're going to be there.
Must I?
Why is this such a chore? You went last time. Though you did all you could to disrupt things, as I recall. Brazenly rambling on about clear-cutting a nearby forest to secure a marching route. And attacking an enemy base, stealing their horses. You were incredibly disruptive, and even rude.
I was offering my honest opinion.
then, you left before we were finished. What do you suppose happened after that?
I have no idea.
Well, the conversation got quite lively. We all began breaking down the viability of your somewhat maniacal plan. And apparently, similar tactics have been used to turn the tides of historic battles.
That may be an exaggeration. Successful armies must be able to handle unexpected situations. That starts with weapon mastery and creative tactics.
If you didn't have so much battlefield experience, you wouldn't be capable of such unique strategies. Which is why we need people like you. People who think creatively to lead the army.
Now you're just massaging my ego.
When have you ever minded? We need you there. Just come on.
Oh no, this isn't right. Now what am I supposed to do?
What's the matter, Mercedes?
I accidentally made this food much sweeter than I wanted.
Let me taste it. Yeah, a little sweet. What if we try adding a few spices?
Huh? This is delicious! You're an amazing cook, Ash!
My dad used to own a restaurant. I helped out a lot around the kitchen, even as a little kid.
Wow, that's a lot of responsibility to take on at an early age. No wonder you always work so hard. I might learn something if I watch you cook.
Well, no promises. I just have a little bit of experience, that's all. But look at you, you're great at baking cakes.
It's true that I'm quite good at baking, but I'm not the best when it comes to seasoning. Maybe it's because I don't like spicy food? It's tough to make food taste good when you don't enjoy it. I just had an idea. If the reason I can't cook spicy food is because I don't like it, then all I have to do is eat some spicy food. If I learn to like it, then I'll be better at making it, right?
I don't know, maybe. What makes you say that?
No. None of that matters. Once I've made a decision, I have to go with it. I'll make something spicy right away.
Oh, this won't end well. If I leave her to it, she'll make an even bigger mess.
Hey, Ash, which seasonings should I use? These ones?
Hold on, Mercedes. Let me show you. That one goes best with meat, but for stir-fry, what you really want is this.
Hey, Annette. Hitting the magic books again? Has anyone ever told you that you're pretty cute when you're studying?
Sorry, Sylvain, but I'm trying to think right now. Could you keep quiet for a bit?
How can you stay focused reading a book that thick? With such small print? Is some of that text upside down?
If I use the formula in this line here, the magical energy should... No, that's not right.
You're even cuter when you're working through a difficult problem.
Sylvain, I'm serious. Please be quiet.
Hang on. Look at the third line. You've got the formula wrong.
I said be... Oh, you're right. How did you know that?
Well, I mean, it's written right there.
Most people wouldn't be able to grasp this formula just by glancing at it. Have you read this book before?
Nope, this is the first time. Okay, now that I look at it... Wow, this book makes things way more complicated than they need to be.
And what's your take on this part here?
It's just describing another application for the same formula. This is pretty easy.
You know, you're actually kind of amazing. I've been studying magic for a while now, but even I have trouble with this stuff. You act like all you do is mess around, but are you actually working really hard in secret?
Nah, hanging out with girls is way more fun. I guess I just picked this stuff up somewhere. Life is short, Annette. If you waste it working hard, it'll be over before you know it. Get out in the world. Have some fun.
That's easy for you to say. You're strong and smart without even trying. It's not fair.
Ugh.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be rude.
No, I was just thinking you're pretty cute when you're sulking, you know that?
What is wrong with you?
Hey, I just got lucky with that stuff in the book. I'd normally never be able to outsmart you. Anyway, I'm gonna get out of here and leave you to it.
Got lucky, huh? I'm not so sure about that.
Well, that does it. It might be tough, but I won't accept second place. Let's go, me. I can do this. I'm gonna finish this whole book before sundown.
That's the third time this month. Well, that's that. Father never relents. Oh, Professor! Hello! Did you need something?
Well, that is... I was just tossing out something I have no need of. It's important to keep our spaces clean, after all.
You'd do well to remember that too, Professor. A clean space makes for a clean mind, or some such. Getting rid of things you have no need for is the first step to managing one's belongings in an economical way. Does that surprise you? Perhaps it seems ill-befitting someone of noble birth to care about such things. Despite my family's nobility, we've never been particularly wealthy. So my father raised me to be conservative with my resources, paring down when necessary. He also encouraged me to keep my living spaces immaculate. So the two go hand in hand, I suppose. Yes, he's a good person. Even when managing our territory used up most of our family's resources, he still went out of his way to ensure my comfort. Oh, just a scrap of paper. It was already written on, so no good for note-taking. And obviously, I can't use it to clean my lance. So I tossed it. No need to hang on to inconsequential things, you know. Professor, did you come to check on me for any particular reason? I hope Sylvain and Felix aren't getting into trouble as they tend to do. Oh, well, if there's nothing important, I'll be on my way then. I still have some cleaning to take care of, after all. Talk to you later, Professor.
Your Highness, the hour is late. May I ask where it is you're going?
I'm off to the library for a bit of research before I train. After that, a bath and bed.
Very well. I shall accompany you.
No. There's no need for that. I am a grown man, after all.
You sustained an injury during yesterday's training. My presence may be of use to you.
It was a mere bruise that will heal in no time. No need to fret over me, Dudu.
Are you dissatisfied with me, Your Highness? Please do not hesitate to correct me.
And there it is again.
Yes? What is it?
Well, you often choose to address me as Your Highness. When we first met, you used to call me by my name.
That was because I was unfamiliar with Fodlan's speech. Thinking back, such rude manners were inexcusable.
To be honest, I much preferred it. I feel more comfortable being addressed by my name, rather than with the honorifics that go along with being a prince.
But...
I did not teach you to read and write so that you know how to address me properly. And I brought you to the Academy as my friend, not a vassal.
But Your Highness, a vassal is precisely what I am.
So much has happened since we met, yet we cannot seem to bridge this gap. So be it. I give you leave to return to your quarters. Take an early night and reflect on what I've said. Please.
I couldn't possibly. I said I would accompany you, did I not?
True. But I would much prefer that we take steps to ease this mindset of yours.
My goodness! Sword training again today? Don't overdo it, all right?
I certainly won't, but thanks for your concern, Mercedes. It's more of a hobby than anything, so don't worry too much.
A hobby? How wonderful! I would probably get tired of it, but that's just me.
Didn't you say you hoped to take the sword test soon?
You're right. I completely forgot that's coming up. What should I do?
To be honest, I've been a bit worried as I haven't seen you at the training ground much.
Why didn't you say something sooner if you were so worried about me?
It didn't occur to me that you could have forgotten. But you're right. I should have mentioned it. As an apology, why don't you let me help you with your swordsmanship?
You would do that for me? I'd really appreciate your help.
Okay, but keep in mind that since we're short on time, we may have to overdo it a little.
I don't like to overdo it, but if we must, I'll try my best.
It's settled. Let's begin. Don't tell me you've forgotten how to hold a sword. We have our work cut out for us.
I usually just hold the sword without thinking about my grip, you know? Let's see what happens now that you've shown me the proper way to handle it. I was nervous at first, but just look at me now! Yeah!
Well, I didn't realize offering to help you would mean risking my life.
I'm so sorry. I don't know what happened. I just meant to swing the sword. I didn't think it would go flying like that. I'm impressed with how quickly you can dodge.
Yes, I know you didn't intend to murder me. Though that scare likely took years off my life.
Maybe I'm not cut out for this whole sword fighting thing.
Nonsense. It's far too early to give up. The first time I picked up a sword, I was much like you. It's true that different people are better suited to different things. But if you keep at it and refuse to give up, you're certain to improve.
Do you really think so? Thank you, Dimitri. It's very kind of you to... Oh! There's a rip in your cuff, Dimitri. How do you think...
It seems I didn't dodge your sword fast enough. Don't worry, I can easily repair it.
I'm the one who tore it, so I'll be the one who mends it. How does that sound?
No, please, don't worry yourself over it. Just focus on your exam.
Good morning, Your Highness. Getting in some early training, huh?
Oh, it's not too terribly early. And what about you?
Oh, I'm just going for my morning walk. Hey, maybe you'd like to join me. It's a great way to start the day.
Morning walk? Funny. Gustav always kept the same habit. You really do remind me of your father, Annette.
I hear that a lot. Father was always busy with work, so he wasn't around much. But when he was home, he'd often take me with him for his walks.
Annette, something's been weighing on me. Something I've done terribly wrong. Your father, he worked tirelessly. I don't know if I ever saw him take a rest. I feel as though, in a way, we stole him from you.
I'll admit, it was a bit lonely growing up. But I understand. Father loved his work. No one ever doubted that. Actually, I've been thinking recently that I'd like to talk to you more, Your Highness.
Oh? Any reason in particular?
Father was a man of few words, both with myself and my mother. But sometimes he would tell me about you. So, you don't really feel like a stranger to me. In a way, it's like I've known you for a long time. Almost as though you're my big brother.
Your big brother?
Oh, I'm so sorry. I don't know why I let that slip out. That was rude of me.
No, nonsense. I promise you, I don't mind at all. It's certain that my days would have been filled with more fun if I'd had a little sister like you. What kind of things did Gustav tell you about me? I'd love to hear more on this topic.
Do you really want to know? Well, for one, he used to tell this story about when you were a child and...
You know what? Never mind. I have a bad feeling about where this is going. How about you forget we had this talk altogether? And don't mention it to anyone.
Thank you.
now? Please tell me that wasn't the pin!
What was that noise?
Dadoo! Well, as you can see, the pan kind of exploded. Just a little.
How did you manage that?
I looked away for a moment and the pan just went boom! Ugh, I'm grateful nothing caught fire, but now the kitchen is a mess.
Are you hurt?
Oh, no. I just got a little spooked. I really lucked out, didn't I? That could have turned out much worse.
Indeed. But do not turn your back next time. Your life could depend on it.
Right. Sorry. I'll be more careful from now on.
Let me help you.
Huh?
I will help you clean up.
No, I can't let you do that. This is all my fault. You shouldn't have to help me.
I have time. Let us fix this quickly. We will need to prepare more food before the others arrive at the dining hall.
Oh, you're right. So, after we clean up, you're also gonna help me cook?
You object?
Of course not. I'm just so sorry to bother you with this.
Felix, have some tea.
Oh.
Sorry, but we're all out of cakes. Should I bake some more?
Please, don't.
Oh, your clothes are so dirty. Let me wash them for you.
Mercedes, what's wrong with you?
There's nothing wrong with me. I'm just making tea. Is there something wrong with that?
You're not my mother. You don't have to bother with all this. I can do without it.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to be rude. You just remind me so much of my little brother.
I do?
Yes, his name is Emil. We have different fathers, but we grew up in the same household. That is, until I was about 8 or 9 years old. I haven't seen him since then.
Sorry to state the obvious, but I'm not your brother. I'm not Emil. Can't you find someone else to bother?
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'll leave you alone. Please help yourself to more tea if you'd like. I can leave the pot. Goodbye.
I am me, Felix Hugo Fraldarius. There is no one else. Brother.
Are you here to study too?
I am. It's quiet here. Easier to concentrate.
It really is. Hey, would you like to study together? We can help each other out if we get stuck.
Oh, yes. We'll get a lot more done working together.
What's the matter, Ash?
This question's got me stumped. A ballista inside a castle is ready to fire at enemies outside. What angle should be used for the shot? Assume the ballista is the same as those in Garrig Mach. Ignore the effects of wind. This is for defensive strategy, isn't it? Why is it so complicated? Don't you just aim and fire?
It may help to focus on maximizing target accuracy to reduce your miss rate. To start, let's sort out the setup. Let's see. Using these ballista specifications, if the ballista corals follow this trajectory, they'll hit the enemy lines, right?
Oh, that makes sense, because the enemy line will be here.
That's it! Okay, now try using that same technique and applying it to this other problem.
If the walls are this high and the enemy lines are at that distance... Oh, I think I see!
I knew you'd get it.
Wow. I didn't expect math, of all things, to be useful in a siege. This is tough. Numbers are not my strong suit. But this really is the sort of thing you have to know if you want to command troops.
That's true, but not everyone is good with numbers. That's why we have tacticians do these calculations for us, or prepare them before we go to battle. A century ago, the Empire's mathematicians played a huge role in the Battle of the Wall of Fodlan.
I had no idea. Hey, you really know what you're doing, Annette.
You think so?
Definitely. You've obviously done a lot of studying. I really admire that.
I suppose I have. Studying is a necessity if you want the advantage over your enemies. But necessity aside, it's nice to hear you say that.
You think I'd cheat? On you, baby? Never. Come on. You should know me better than that. You're the only one for me, I swear. Hey, if you don't believe me, well... Oh, I get it. If I'm not your type, do you want me to introduce you to some other guys who have crests? They're all nobles, just like me.
What? That isn't why I'm... You're worse than I thought!
I just want you to be happy. You know, get what you're after. I hate seeing a girl cry. Especially one as beautiful as you. So, you know, maybe we... So, Professor, do you enjoy spying on people? You look like you've got something to say, so say it. Hey, that was between me and her, not you. But you know how it is. Most relationships, they end in heartbreak. Anyway, I don't know why she's so upset about me dating other girls. She didn't care before she found out, so why does she care now? I really do hate seeing a girl cry. Come on, it's hard on me too. If only I had someone to comfort me. Professor, it's okay if you want to console me. I happen to have some exquisite tea back in my quarters. You could come by and we could chat about love. Calm down, it was only a joke. You've really got no sense of humor, you know that? Mercedes! You look divine as always. Are you off to pray?
Oh, hello, Sylvain. I was just on my way to pray. How did you guess?
Well, because I've been watching your lovely...
Oh, I get it. You're the type who's always looking at girls, aren't you?
I won't lie. I do enjoy beholding women. But I don't mean it like that with you. I know I sound like a dope. I think you're special.
Oh, really? You think I'm so clumsy that I need someone to watch over me. Is that why you can't take your eyes off me?
You're beautiful, and I mean that. You're... How can I put it without sounding even worse? Okay, here goes. I want to get to know you better. As friends, I mean.
I don't know where to begin.
Well, what's something you like?
I like to pray. I've been praying regularly since I was a child.
You grew up in the Empire, didn't you?
That's right. I was raised in House Bartels.
Bartels? I thought you were born to House Martreats.
It's a complicated story. I'm not sure that it's a very interesting one, but I'm happy to share it with you.
I don't mean to be nosy, if it's too personal.
Oh no, I don't mind. I wasn't trying to hide anything from you. House Martreats fell shortly before I was born.
Oh.
My father passed away while my mother was still pregnant with me, so she had nowhere to go. After I was born, my mother ended up marrying the head of House Bartels. Shortly after, my mother bore a true Bartels child who bore a crest. She and I were treated as though we were no longer useful to the family after that.
You think the Bartels were just using her to secure a crest?
They must have been. My mother and I were removed from the family and forced to flee to a church in the kingdom. I abandoned the Bartels' name and took up our old family name again.
So you grew up in a church? Okay, it makes more sense now why you're praying all the time.
Yes, praying! I forgot that I was on my way to pray.
Right, and I interrupted you. Well, see you around, Mercedes.
Yes, see you.
House Bartels wanted a crest, and ruined other people's lives to get one. These idiots are all the same.
You there, youngster. Won't you listen to this old man's troubles? I was born and raised right here in this town. I spent my whole life here. My daughter lives in the Empire, and she sent me a letter to ask if I was keeping up with my daily worship.
Well, hello there, Professor. Is this a friend of yours? Is that so? I was sure you two knew each other. Is there something we can do for you, good sir?
Oh, what a lovely young lady. I was just telling this kind soul a story.
Really? What's troubling you?
Well, I was thinking of going to daily prayer, but my leg's been acting up and I can't walk properly.
How terrible! That's no good at all. May I be of assistance? I'd be happy to lend a shoulder and escort you to the chapel.
Would you? Oh, I'd be most grateful to you. Thank the goddess for sending this young lady to me today.
We'll need your help too, Professor. Here, sir, take my arm. Splendid work, Professor. He really seemed to appreciate our assistance. I don't think I did anything particularly deserving of praise. I'm just happy that I could help. You did a great job cheering him up on your own. Putting a smile on someone's face always seems to brighten up the day. Is something wrong? You're giving me a strange look. How should I put this? I suppose it's just second nature to me. It's difficult to describe, but I can usually tell when someone is worried about something. Back there, I could tell that both you and the old man were in distress. I spent a good amount of my life living in the church. Maybe that's why I'm so good at identifying these things? Did I not mention that before? I spent nearly 10 years of my life in the Church of Fargus. Many came to us with their troubles. In my own time of need, I once ran to the church myself, and they helped me. May I share something with you, Professor? It's about a dream of mine. I'd like to work in the church one day. I want to be like the priest who helped me. Never mind. It's not a very realistic dream. Please, forget I said anything. If I were someone else, perhaps a commoner without a crest or stature, maybe things would be different. It's a bit sad, but this is the way things have to be. After all, only the goddess can decide our fates.
Dudu, hey. Oh, I'm sorry. I hope I'm not bothering you. Looks like you're pretty deep in thought.
Does it?
I just wanted to stop by and ask. It was your turn to cook last night, yeah?
Yes.
Well, it was great. I was wondering if you could give me some tips. You know, teach me how to cook. I hear a girl loves a man who can cook.
Sylvain.
Yeah?
You are from Fargus. You must understand how it appears for you to spend time with one from Dusker. To be near me is to invite tedious misunderstanding.
Oh, please. I don't care who misunderstands what about me. I talk to who I want. Besides, I believe the Dusker people are innocent.
You do?
Fargus and Dusker have been friendly since, heck, forever. So why would our old friends from Dusker just up and assassinate our king? It doesn't make sense. Sure, there are probably folks from Dusker who don't like Fargus. But do I think there's enough of them to mount an attack and slaughter the king and his whole company of elite guards?
It is difficult to believe, considering the discrepancy in skill and number.
Right? At most, I can see a misguided group of people from Dusker conspiring with someone else who had plans to dethrone the king. Maybe they were even lured into participating and used as scapegoats. Regardless, it doesn't concern you or the rest of your people. A person can't be judged by the worst of their kind. Or where would any of us be? Besides, people like to talk about me anyway, so let them talk. Okay, you're making a weird face. What did I say?
I have misjudged you. I was under the impression you only cared about women.
Well, I'm glad I've cleared up that misunderstanding. But really, there's no way I'm the only person who figured all that out. There must be people who think like me in Ferdiad, including His Highness.
Agreed. But whatever the truth, we are still perceived as traitorous assassins.
Once a misunderstanding takes hold, it isn't easy to clear the air. Not without solid evidence of the truth. But even if we found evidence that your people are innocent, those negative sentiments wouldn't disappear overnight. The only thing that can change that is time and effort. Depressing, isn't it?
Time and effort. Yes, I believe you're right.
Man, that got serious. Shouldn't we lighten things up with a nice cooking lesson?
Very well.
Hi there, Ash. Here to do some reading as well, I take it? Ash?
Huh, Ingrid! You gave me a start. How long have you been standing there?
Not too long. Apologies for startling you. Must be a great book for you to be so deeply engrossed in it. What has you so captivated?
It's quite an old book. One of the really old legends of Fargus.
Aha! It must be the Sword of Kyphon then, yes?
Oh, so you know it!
Oh yes, I know it quite well. I read it often as a child. In fact, I read it so much that my personal copy fell apart. I brought it everywhere with me. I adore that book. The tale of the warrior Kyphon, whose devotion and loyalty enabled his best friend Lug to become king. He went to great lengths to see things through.
Exactly! I love the image of him charging forward into the fray, ready to take on any obstacle in the name of his king!
Indeed! He was the very picture of the perfect knight. In my opinion, the best chapter is right around the middle of the book.
Ah, the part about the war of the eagle and lion? That's my favorite part! In a flash, Kyphon's sword flew from its scabbard. The knight parried the assassin's blade mere inches from the spine of his king.
Kyphon's blade hummed like the wind, slashing the enemy's throat. In mere moments, their forces lay vanquished, decimated by his mighty blows. I can recite the entirety of it if you like. I never grow weary of that tale, the pinnacle of knighthood, with all its struggles and glory.
I know just what you mean. I never get tired of it. Some people laugh at me for reading these old tales, but I'll never outgrow them. I'm glad to find someone who shares my enthusiasm.
I'm glad of it as well. Tell me, what other books do you enjoy, Ash?
Well, the first one I ever read was Lug and the Maiden of Wind.
Oh, you have fantastic taste! That story is another favorite. The final chapter makes me tear up every time.
I know. When I first read it, I just couldn't get that ending out of my head.
It seems we have much in common. I look forward to chatting again sometime.
I'd love to. Yes, let's.
Did you want something? I see. If you have the time, then please assist me. I am to water the flowers in the greenhouse. Thank you. Only do not water the ones in that corner. They are from Dusker. They require a dry environment. The roots will rot otherwise. I know enough. I owe you a debt of gratitude. In both the extracurricular activities here at the Academy and on the battlefield, your presence has been instrumental in the defense of His Highness. You have my sincerest thanks. To me, it is not nothing. Was there something else you wanted? Then please, excuse me.
Yeah.